We begin every single year here at Cross Connection Church talking a little bit about our vision, life in connection with God, one another, and the world through Jesus. So today we were talking about connecting with God, and kind of a follow-up on what we were talking about, some questions that kind of arise out of that is, first, how do we really experience that in a practical way? What does it look like to connect with God on a regular basis in a practical way? And I mentioned six different things that we can do to strengthen and maintain our connection with God when we first enter into that relationship. Of course, you first have to develop the relationship with God, and that comes through accepting Jesus Christ into your life as Lord and Savior. The Gospel of John, chapter 1, it says that as many as received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to be called the children of God, who are born of the Spirit. They're not born of flesh and blood, but they're born of the Spirit. A couple chapters later, when you get into John chapter 3, Jesus talks more about that. Maybe read that this week in John chapter 3, where he talks about being born again with a very religious man, Nicodemus. I mean, there was probably no more religious man in all of Israel during the time of Jesus than Nicodemus. But even though he did all the temple things and he observed all the feasts and all the different things of the law, he still was disconnected from God. And so Jesus told him, Nicodemus, unless you're born again, you will not receive the kingdom of God. You're not going to see it. So you're still far from God. So as many as received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to be called the children of God. So we first develop that relationship by receiving Christ Jesus as Lord and Savior, by receiving him as Savior, confessing our sins, and allowing him to forgive us by his death on the cross. But then we strengthen and maintain that relationship with God through, I mentioned six things. There's probably others that we could come up with, but six really clear things I think are helpful. First, worship. And unfortunately, in our day, we think that worship is just singing songs to God. And that can be a way to worship. I think that singing songs of praise is one of the avenues that we can worship God, but it's certainly not the only way. And maybe for some people who just, they don't sing, they maybe don't think they have a good voice, that might be kind of hard for them. So I think one of the ways you can worship God is to spend some time in the morning thinking upon who God is and what God has done. And of course, the Bible is really helpful for this. If you read through some of the Psalms, you start to get a picture of what God's like, his love, his care, his forgiveness, his grace, all of these things. When you start to think about who God is, you can feel your heart begin to worship him. It's just like if you take some time and start thinking about the person in your life that you love, maybe your kids or your spouse, as you start to think about all the aspects of who that person is, you can sometimes even feel like a smile come to your face. You start to remember who they are, and you feel a warmness in your heart. That's kind of an adoration of that person. Same thing with God. You can spend time in the morning thinking upon who God is and what he's done. And I have found that if you find a quiet and sometimes like a beautiful place, go find a place up in the hills where you can see the sunrise and you start to think about God, your heart will begin to worship and adore God. So one of the ways we practically are able to connect with God is through worship. And then of course, an aspect of that is prayer, spending time talking to God. And sometimes our prayers can become real formal and we think we have to follow some pattern. I just talk to God. I talk to God like I'm talking right now. I talk to God while I'm driving in my car. I talk to God while I'm walking around my house. I talk to God when I'm sitting at my desk, wherever I may be. I'm talking to God and I'm sharing with him my concerns, my needs, my cares, my fears, whatever it may be. And I'm bringing those things to God. One of the beautiful things about prayer, Philippians chapter 4 says, "Be anxious for nothing, but by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and God's peace will guard your heart." That's a beautiful thing, that we have a plan from the scriptures. God has given to us how we can experience life without anxiety, without fear, without all the things that kind of lean upon us, weigh upon us. And we come to God with our prayers, our petitions, letting him know the things that we're fearful about, the things that we need, and bringing those to him in prayer. We connect with God. He draws near to us as we draw near to him, the scriptures say. And then the third thing, of course, is through the scriptures. I mentioned in the message today, thelisteningplan.com. You can go there, check it out, or just get a Bible reading plan. There are hundreds of them. Search Google for Bible reading plan. You'll find one. Go on the YouVersion Bible app, find a Bible reading plan. Even if it's just reading one verse a day, start with that. Start with one verse, start with 5 minutes, and then add a little bit to it every single day. If you start off your day in worship, and prayer and in God's word, I guarantee you this week, you will experience God's presence to a greater extent, and you will know what it is to be connected to God.